Hello, hello, chat. Welcome, welcome. Tonight is the Salt Factory, Niv Mizzet edition. This is gonna be ridiculous. I'm really excited about it. Before we get started, I just want to remind y'all that I am streaming Monday, and that is it next week. I will be headed to Missouri for Christmas, and I won't be back until the next Salt Factory pod on the 29th with this Jonah the Unifier. So, apparently I hate myself this December. I have some wonderful guests with me here tonight. All war criminals in their own right. Lovely guests. Say hello.
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 I'd love for you to introduce yourselves, and we can go in whatever the current turn order is, which means, Mald, you're first.
Hi, everybody. My name's Maldhound. I am judge, jury, and executioner of whether or not your cards are fuckable. Niv Mizzet was one of the first commanders I ever built, and I built them for $69. Nice. This nice. Version is 2000, because get fucked.
I love it. Oh, I didn't even look to see if I had a usable 7.
That's crazy about you.
So crazy. Fredo. Who the hell are you?
I'm Fredo, or Virtue underscore MTG, or actually we are changing that to just Fredo MTG at the start of the new year. Ooh. We're executing the Virtue username. No one calls me that in the community. Let's be real, I'm just Fredo to you all.
We do love your name. So
thank
hard.
You. I appreciate that. Fun fact about me, I own 2 pet rats that you may or may not see during the streaming if my partner puts them on my shoulder.
Oh my god, please let your partner nice. Put them on your shoulder.
It depends on how eepy they are. Sometimes we'll have 2. But I'll definitely call it out or point to them when that happens. I'm also playing Niv Mizzet, but we're going to start cloning them. There's going to be that one, I forgot the name of the equipment, but the one that's... Helm of the Host. There will be Sakashima's. There will be John Irenicus's Vile Duplication. There will be Mirror Hall's. It's just gonna get out of hand. Unless I get pew-pewed to death by everybody else first. That may happen. But thank you for having me.
Of course. I love having you on the stream. I'm really happy that you guys have all played on the stream before, and you've all been in a salt factory before, which I think actually makes this a little bit more terrifying, because you know what to expect. And again, you're already war criminals. Ham. Hi.
Hello, hello, everybody. How you doing? My name's Graham. I go by HamHawks42 on the internet. I stream here on Twitch primarily. I am the type of content creator who doesn't like calling himself a content creator, because I really don't like posting short form videos or YouTube content. I have so much respect for people who can do it, but I'm much more a fan of the long form action. So twitch.tv/hamox42. I love to see you over there. We stream Monday through Friday, doing arena stuff. Fun fact that I recently found out, I did a stress test on the direct challenge bug that Wizards claimed to have gotten fixed, and it actually worked today. Ooh. So it looks like they did actually get that fixed. So that's what that. I'm on cloud 9, honestly.
Shout out to bug fixes.
Yes, bug fixes. Anybody, all the developers and QA folks, all like 3 of you working on MTG Arena, man, you're doing Lord's work. Thank you for getting it done. We appreciate you.
One of them got fired.
Oh yeah, of course. Yeah.
Well, yeah, also that.
Yeah, sad days. But anyway, but yes, and I'm doing Niv Mizzet. This one, so I pride myself on being able to build with just the bulk crap I have lying around and make a functional deck out of it. So we'll test it. The Moxfield value on this deck is $93. So if I win this, y'all have no excuse. I'm just going to say that right now. I'm looking forward to it. And yeah, everyone, thanks so much.
If you start winning, I'm deleting the OG duel from my Moxfield list, and then we're on even footing, sir.
That's fair. That'll do it. Yes, absolutely. No, I'm looking forward to this. And yeah, no, Fredo, Maltown, I'm very much looking forward to getting to jam with you. I know this is going to be a good time. So yeah. And yeah, Bruna, thanks so much for having us.
Fuck yeah, I love you guys. Shout out really quick. Ham and I co-host a show called Hot Soup. It is a commander base. Show where we talk mostly about jank, and I do weird
and tangent nonsensically about all kinds of things. It's a lot of fun.
So we talk about decks we're building, the weird janky things that we put in it, stuff that we love. Mm-hmm. and recently a What If Universes Beyond series that I'm absolutely going to continue. The first one was Letterkenny, so if you're interested in that, that episode is up on YouTube. Episode 3 and 4 are going up this week. I have to upload them.
That episode was a blast because we both created a bunch of little Letterkenny cards with it. It started as a DM, like, wouldn't it be funny if? And we expected, like, yeah, we could do like 10 minutes at the top of the episode, just some fun whole designs. Episode. Next thing we know, 45 minutes later, we're like, okay, what if? You know,
I made 15 cards. I may have overdone.
They're all bangers, if I may say.
Thank you.
It was a good time. Anyway, tons of fun.
If only we could have a fight of those decks for the Salt Factory.
Oh my goodness.
Maybe we should do that. Ah, crap. That's
I think the Wayne deck would crush it, I'm not gonna lie. Squirrely Dan's got hands too. Anyway. Yeah.
Thank you. I'm absolutely playing skids.
Kindred skids, let's go. All right.
All right. And of course, BrujaGaming. My Niv Mizzet deck is like the anti Niv Mizzet deck. I am absolutely not even shameful about the fact that I built pretty meta for these pods at this point, because I like the challenge of thinking about playing against myself. Like, what is the best way to counter it? And I feel like having to think that way helps me become a better deck builder, which means I have no excuse for the trash that I currently play, but that's neither here nor there. Anyway, my Niv Mizzet deck is almost all permanents. There are no sorceries, there are 5 instances, and they are all counterspells. That is it. I am gonna ping off of everybody else's efforts, and I have every damage doubling, tripling, whatever I could find in there. So unfortunately, we're gonna have to do math, which I'm terrible at. So somebody who wasn't an art major is gonna have to help me.
I'm an English major, don't look here.
All right, it's down to you two.
I do words good. I don't number.
I do words good.
I'm a math boy.
Done. You're the issue. You're already the issue. Randomize. I'm not going first. Fuck you. Fredo.
Alrighty.
If everybody has a keepable 7, we could get to step it.
Yeah.
I'm gonna go ahead and scoot over to this corner then. Haha.
I'll draw for turn. We'll play a reflecting pool that taps for nothing.
Uh-oh.
The only person to ever play a land and have color fixing disadvantage.
We'll pass.
Alright. You sure you're not gonna do anything else there? Yeah.
I'm not sure how to produce land out of this thing yet, so we'll wait a turn.
Alright. I'm gonna rock out a Silver Bluff Bridge. It's the artifact dual land. It's all indestructible, and I shall pass.
That's crazy. I'm gonna do the first abominable thing and hit an off-color fetch and crack it, going down 1 to go look for an island. It's gonna be Volatile Fjord, but other than that, I will pass the turn.
It's happening.
Draw for turn. Okay. I can't see shit. Hold on. Do I have my glasses? I'm so old. The problem is it's too small, but if I make it bigger, then it's wild on the screen. So everybody pretend like you can't see my shit.
And you had a killer, that's what she said for a second, until you mentioned the screen. It's like, I don't know if that... I don't think that's right.
Alright, I can't see shit, so I'm just gonna play an island and pass her.
Oh, it's back to me. We'll make better choices by playing a command tower. Tap for 2. It don't matter because it's a Felwar stone, and as long as my opponents control, y'all know. All right, I'll pass.
Yeah. That's just another arcane signet in this pod.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Unless y'all be just playing off color fetches, but
we'll rock out a command tower. I'm gonna go ahead and play. Here's a budget card that I'm pretty happy with. Ominous Seize. Ooh, whenever I draw a card, I may put a foreshadow counter on it, remove 8 of them, and I can create an 8/8 blue kraken. So
I took it out last minute to put a curse in there, so whoever irritated me, I could curse.
Groovy. And that is my turn. Over to draw some cards.
All right, I will draw. Oh shit, yeah. Okay, we're going to mountain, thought vessel. I have no maximum hand size. Fear me, and then pass.
You know, in most decks, I feel like that's overrated. In this one, I think you're onto something there.
Whoops. Just realized I didn't change my music. Whoopsie daisy. Don't want to get muted.
Okay. Right. And Gozer, thank you. Yeah, the Visions of Phyrexia art, which it looks really pretty in person, I'm not going to lie.
Is it my turn?
Indeed.
Yes.
Oh, sorry. Drop a turn. I've got steam vents untapped, so I take two. I shall tap those two for a thought vessel. And pass.
Okay. Could you get your own personality for like one turn?
Jeez, all right.
Fight me.
I'm just saying.
Fight me.
Two of us have gone dual land, basic land, thought vessel.
I did.
And one of us went before the other.
That's true, too. I played a game once on I don't even know what self factor it was. Everybody but me had a turn one vampiric tutor. It was very odd.
Oh my goodness. Lord.
But past her.
All right. Looks like I'm the only one on track to having Niv out, because those rocks ain't tapping for colors. We'll tap for a combination of colors that equal to two red at least, and we're going to cast a Sulfum Mayhem Dominus. Non-combat damage I would deal is dealt double, and if I get more replacement effects, y'all get to decide what order to do them in, because that's the new discourse, right? I'll pass the turn.
All right.
I think we have to kill him now.
I mean, it sounds good. Yeah. I mean, wait, what?
Player removal is removal.
Target player shits his pants. Coming at you.
That resolves. All right. Stormcarved Coast coming on down. And hey, guess what? I got some rocks to tap for colors. That's is it Signet? Check it out.
Oh.
And then I'm going to go ahead and tap the Is it Signet for a friggin' Cold Steel Heart. That's going to come and tap. It's really solid, and I'm going to have it tap for blue. It's just, hey, it's a two-mana rock that just does the thing. That's what I'm looking for. So yeah, I got five mana sources down, all of which produce the colors I need. And that's one foreshadow counter. And I'm going to go ahead and pass it.
All right. I'm going to lay down... wrong card. I'm going to lay down off-color fetch number two. Go down to 38 to get a Molten Tributary. Which ETB's tapped. Then I'm going to tap two and leave one blue up to cast Cathartic Reunion. I'm going to discard Dramatic Reversal and a Mountain to draw three. So real of me. I pass.
Discarding Dramatic Reversal. Tell me you have Isochron Scepter in your deck, but not in your hand without telling me.
I don't have Isochron. I actually, I think Isochron is a bitch-ass card, and I don't like anybody that plays it. I'm kidding. You have to play it in some
Okay. I totally have one in this, yes.
Yeah. I shall play a Training Center. I have more than two opponents, therefore it comes out on top.
I don't have Dramatic Reversal in here, though, for the record. But yeah.
That's funny. Together.
I just want to put an Arcane Denial or a Counterspell on it. That's all.
I'm going to tap three. And play Aristic Study.
I hear that card's good.
Alrighty. Untap. I'm going to play a Valakut Awakening on that thing. Yep. And I'll tap for three, at least one of which is blue, and cast Copyright Infringement, playing my own Risk Study. I'll pay the one so that other people can't have theirs. I'll pass the turn.
Yes. I don't know why I'm surprised.
Well, that's one of the fun things about this series is there's obviously staples. That are just gonna see in the decks because they make sense. Like the Adeline pod I had, I think was the most consistent across decks. But then of course there was the flavorful war crime personality piece of each individual. And shocking no one, Queen of Cardboard kicked our fucking ass.
I mean, it happens. Yeah. All right, so I think I get to be that guy.
Yeah.
I'm going to go 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The Lizard Wizard
Lizard
is on the
Wizard.
Field.
King Wizard. Right?
And all right.
We'll each draw one, I presume.
Indeed you will, because that was tapping out.
Fucking each one of us is playing fair.
And all right.
Oh, yeah, you cast a spell.
Mm-hmm.
I did, in fact, cast a spell. I'm down to 4 cards in hand for the moment. But, yeah. We're Niven. That's my turn.
You know what's crazy about me is I also have Ominous Seas in this deck. I did not put Rhystic Study in this deck.
What?
Yeah, because I played...
Was that still just a little too far out the budget? Or,
He has
I wanted to play things I like. I'm paying 2 to pay for both of your fuck ass Rhystic Studies, and then I'm passing the turn.
Yo, that's fair though. Okay.
Get it. Mm-mm. Oh yeah, we're living for a living, baby.
Play a fiery inlet for turn. I should probably do the thing, but I think I'm gonna do this instead. I'm gonna tap everybody for an Aetherflux Reservoir.
Oh my god.
Are you paying the one?
And I am paying the one.
Sounds good.
Best turn.
Alright.
I hate it here.
That's how it is.
Alright, well, untap.
Wait, look, I probably would have built this in anyway because that's fucking hilarious to me. I love Aetherflux.
How much tap land do y'all got?
I have 4 for you.
4.
I have 4 lands, yes.
I'm no math major, but that sounds like 12 mana to me.
It does.
I mean, so, if that's a mana geyser, I believe that's exactly,
Yeah, we'll produce one of them.
Oh,
that seems good. That seems good.
I will not be paying the 1 for that.
Hey, and that's an instant or sorcery spell, so I draw a card.
Mm-hmm. And you got 1 damage on a little.
Oh, I do have 1 damage on. Hey, Brujaja, thank you so much for having us. I'm gonna ping your face for 1.
That makes sense.
Because that's an Aetherflux Reservoir just chilling there, and I have to hit the host first at least once. I just
no, it's mandatory.
Yep, it's very important.
So I got 12 of those.
You get your C's counter, Ham.
Oh yeah, thank you. I know everybody gets 1. You're not gonna remind me next time, I'm sure. Thank you. I don't normally play Is It, you know.
Well, there's a fucking Aetherflux and Assault Them on the other half of the table. I may keep reminding you of things.
I appreciate that. Thank you. You know where the Krakens are going. Oh yeah.
We got 12 red mana, so we're gonna use 5 of that to cast the Gilded Lotus. I will be paying 1, going down to 6 red mananas, and for Bruce Ristic, we'll tap the Gilded Lotus, use 3 more of those red mananas, for not my own Niv Mizzet.
As you should.
We got, we'll pay for the Ristic Study again for the Niv Mizzet, and then for the final 2 red mananas, we're getting a Mind Stone. And that one I will not pay, so, Brew, you get to draw.
Whee!
And that's it for me. I feel like I've done enough.
Are you sure?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I mean, you can make a solid argument that, yes, enough has been done.
Good to go.
Oh, yeah, that's me, isn't it? I'm over here just
indeed.
Being like, I wonder why the game's not progressing. Oh, yeah, because I'm a boner. Got it. All right.
Happens Shocking. All the time.
I know. It's crazy. Yeah. Mm-hmm. All right, cool. I'm gonna go ahead and rock out the Mountania, and then one, 2, 3 for a Gutter Snipe. Whenever I cast an instant sorcery spell, deals 2 damage to each opponent.
Will you be paying the 1 twice?
That's a good question.
At least pay for the motherfucker that's got Sulfim out.
Yeah, I will be paying that one.
Yeah,
enjoy yourself. Right.
Yes, please.
Treat yourself. All right. Yeah. All right. Cool. And then I'm going to go ahead and pay 2 And I can't help but notice all of them is a 5-4.
Yes, this is true.
I'm going to cast a Volcanic Spite targeting Solfim. And when I cast that, I got some triggers. Gutter Snipe is going to ping everybody for 2. And then Niv is going to do what Niv do. Where... Yeah. I get to draw a card there.
I also get a draw off my own Niv, I believe?
Indeed you do. Yeah. Because it's whenever a player, and I am in fact a player. So
we'll draw, and I will direct 2 of that damage at the Gutter Snipe.
Alright, cool. And the my Niv Mizzet trigger is going to put the last piece of damage on Solfim.
This is already getting fucking stupid.
Yeah. And so, yeah, so the Volcanic Spite is going to be hitting...
It's like turn 5.
In response, I will pay 4 life and put an indestructible... Yep. That. But and paying the 1 for Solfim.
Okay, you have to... is it discarding cards that you have to do for
discard
that?
Discard 2 cards. I will discard a Jace's Archivist and a Phantasmal Image.
Cool. And then, as the other part of Volcanic Spite resolving, I may put a card from my hand on the bottom of my library, and if I do draw a card, I'm going to do that. I'm going to put this card, because it is doo-doo garbage and a part of a very budget mana base. I'm going to tuck that in the bottom, hide my shame so y'all don't see it. And then I'm going to draw another card, which is...
Why is there shame in a doo-doo mana base?
My doo-doo mana base.
You already have Niv Mizzet out. Like,
I do have Niv Mizzet out. It's pretty red.
You're fucking fine.
Hey, that's off a couple of 2 mana rocks. That's all. That's the only reason I did that. And then I got 1 more trigger there from my senior Niv. I don't really have any good hits. So yeah. And the Chasm Skulker is still just a 1-1, but again, I, you know, Mald, I appreciate kind of where you're coming from. So yeah, Fredo, I'm just going to ping you in the face for 1. So yeah.
Absolutely valid.
All right, cool.
God bless you.
Yeah, oh, right. It's all good, man. All good. And I believe that's going to be my turn. So.
Okay.
I could attack, not going to. All right.
But in my next turn,
are you
I'm going to uptick.
Like,
Chasm
should we be
Skulker.
Thankful that you could attack, but you didn't?
Total flex. I mean, I could attack. I'm not even going to bother.
I'm going to drop, a island, and then I would like to formally request... Actually, I'm not going to do that. I'm going to do something reasonable. I'm going to play the...
Oh, that fucking
third
dude.
Path Iconoclast.
I love him.
He's pretty great.
I have him in here for sure.
I'm going to...
There's 2 Rhystic Taxes for that one.
Pay both of those because fuck you. and then I will... Let's see. Then I'll pass.
Okay. An Illant. Great place to be. It's very annoying that I pulled 1 of 2 fucking colorless mana rocks. It's quite annoying.
It's unfortunate.
It's so unfortunate. You could do that. Can I do that?
Yeah, I've got like 7 rocks in the deck. Every other one produces colored mana.
Alright.
Damn.
I shall tap 1. 2, 3, what are you? Forget how you were. 4, and pay a life. Oops. So these are still alive. And play this fucking guy. I actually can't read this.
Will you be paying the 1 for me, bro?
No. This time.
Okay.
Oh, you fuck.
What?
I will draw, and then I will dome Hamhocks for 2.
I deserve that. Yep.
Yeah, so if a red source would deal an amount of non-combat damage to an opponent, that source deals equal to his power.
So currently 4, but we'll see what happens. Yep.
Well, it's just if... Yeah. And then if he dies, he becomes a land. Which is fun.
Right. And you do the thing with the stuff.
I mean, I just like this dude. I want to make a brawl deck with him. He seems fun. Anyway, pass turn.
Alrighty.
Don't worry about my ominous blue mana.
Yeah. We'll draw... I did a viewer challenge once and they played Sunshot Militia and I was like, ah, that card's not all that great. And then O'Hare's like, oh, crap.
I gained a life from Aetherflux, so I actually even on that. Nice.
You'll be taking two from me though, bro.
You are the worst, Fredo.
Thank you. I will be playing a Mirrored Landscape tapped. And then I said what I came here to do, so we'll do the thing. Tap, 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 tap. At least one of which is blue. I'm going to cast Sakashima of a Thousand Faces. Mm. And we'll tap the Warstone to pay for the tax. On ETB, I'll have Sakashima become a copy of Niv Mizzet. And then we'll go to combat. And I will send my indestructible Sylphim over at him, and Niv over at Maldhound.
No blocks here.
Yeah, no block. Well, I can't block, so I take five.
Alrighty. We'll pass the turn.
Here we go.
Did you pay for Ristic?
For the Sakashima, yeah.
Can't remember. I figured, but I can't remember.
Alright. On my card for turn, I'm gonna put one damage on Sakashima. And then I'm gonna proceed to go 1, 2, 3 for a Saheeli, Sublime Artificer.
Nice.
Third path iconoclast at home. Alright. Because she says whenever I cast a non-creature spell.
Are you paying the one?
You're gonna pay the one. I suggest at least only paying it for me, because otherwise there's 4 damage on the stack.
And that's...
I cannot do any damage to you if you pay the one for
it's stupid and I don't like it. I'll pay Fredo's one, because ow. Oh. Alright, and yeah, Brew, treat yourself. Enjoy yourself. I don't believe I played my... No, I did play my land for turn. Did I? Probably. Kind of thing I should just know. All right. Then I'm going to go ahead and pay one, drop my land, because, you know.
That's special. How you do.
That's how we do, baby.
That's how we do all in right. The streets.
Absolutely. I did... There is a land. I have no idea where it fell. Man, it was on tap, too. Oh, well. I'll find it. I'm then going to go ahead and play Faithless Looting, because we can.
There you go.
Oh.
When I draw, casting that, so we get the Niv-Mizzet trigger first. I draw a card, and I'm going to pay Fredo's one again. Drawing the card off of Niv-Mizzet, I'm going to put another damage on Sakashima. That's now two. And then that's another foreshadowing. Man, all these triggers. I don't know how you Izzet Mages do it. All right. And then we draw two cards, then discard two cards. I'm going to discard two mountains, because I'm shitty with mountains. And that's two more damage on your dude, and I get a servo.
So fucking wild. I love this so much.
Yeah. I'm glad. All right. I'm trying to think. I did have one mana left, but I don't, unfortunately. I miscalculated. Because that's how we do, I guess.
I think I do draw off of the Faithless.
You draw off the cast.
Yeah, you draw off of the thing.
Yes, you do.
So I'll draw twice for each Niv. Yep. And we'll have 4 damage, or well, 2 sets of 2. I will spread the love a little and even out Ham and Brew's life total to 31 each.
I don't like it.
Yeah, that's yeah. Well, so wait, so yeah, you drew. Yeah, okay, yeah. Yep, 2 sets too. And then I'm gonna be a little pissy.
Oh shit.
Got visual on my command tower. There we go. Alright.
There you go.
Yeah, I miscalculated because I'm a bonehead. So. Actually, wait a minute. Target artifact you control becomes a copy of another target artifact or creature you control until end of turn, except it's an artifact in addition to other types. Hell yeah, I'm gonna downtick my Saheeli, turn the servo, into a copy of my Is It signet for the turn.
Delightful.
What a fucking G.
Boom, because it stops being a creature. Let's fucking go. And then, yeah, so I'm going to tap my Is It servo and my command tower for 2 mana. And then I realize I don't actually have a fucking instant in my hand, but I am going to be able to play out a Goblin Electromancer. Nowhere near as sexy as it should have been.
Tempo.
Yeah, exactly. It's a tempo play. Let's go with that. And I don't. I can't pay for Ristic, so fucking treat yourself. Yep.
We'll draw one.
Wait a minute. Yeah.
And I will dome Brew again for 2, and then this time Maldhound for 2.
I've taken my 2.
I don't know why you're going after me. I'm so chill.
You're the only
player that can gain life. The
you
only
gotta
one
get their flux on there.
I can get it back.
Right?
It's fine. Only one.
It's incremental.
Oh yeah, Is it known for only casting one spell a turn? Famous in CEDH for operating under rule of law effects. The red blue deck.
Well, if it makes you
motherfucking liar.
All right, I'm just gonna pass it. Take it away.
You come here onto your own stream and you say this shit to me. Fucking only one.
I swear to God, Mald, if I pull that curse,
card.
I'm fucking putting it on
I
you.
I uptick Chasm Skulker. I'm going to play another fetch land. I'm going to go down to 28 because fuck it. I'm going to pull out Steam Vents. I'm paying the 2 life because fuck it. I go down to 26. I play Niv. I'm paying the 1 for Fredo's Ristic. Draw your card. Take your turn. You fucking deceiver.
I don't understand why I'm a deceiver. I'm so chill. I would play a mountain for turn, which is nice. I needed one of those. I'm also going to play a Mox Opal for nothing.
Are you paying your 1?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. Okay.
You gain 1 life, by the way.
You gain a life. Good for me. And I will tap 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, lose a life. And 6. Or, where'd he go? Niv! And yes, I'm paying the 1. And I gain a life.
Good life. Okay.
So real quick, because this is about to become, I fear, disturbingly relevant.
Uh-oh.
When, now when one of us casts an instant or sorcery, how do we determine the order in which the stack empties? Like, who's trick? Because who gets to apply? Like, which one of us gets to shoot their damage first? Matters a lot.
Non-active player, something. I don't
know. Yeah, the active player goes last. So
right.
with the active player's spell goes or effect goes on the stack first, and then the next person in turn order, theirs goes on the stack next. So it's your turn. And it triggers, you have to pick your target first, but it's going to resolve last.
So on my turn, Bruce will go off first, then yours, Malt, then Ham, then mine. Mm-hmm.
Then yours, yes.
If I cast an instant or sorcery.
I'm realizing that I'm the chump who brought all the instants and sorceries, and you know, I'm just gonna piggyback.
No, it was me too.
Okay.
I had these 2. I just didn't draw all my fucking ramp.
Yeah.
So I'm sitting here hitting land drops like a schmuck.
Mm. Same though.
On curve? What is this? Come on.
Yeah,
alrighty.
Lands. I'm getting flooded.
And you said you pass ever?
Yes.
Okie dokes. We'll go to my turn on draw. I have 2 Niv triggers off of the draw, so I will not go after my fellow dragons or their creatures, but we will just continue to go for face. Brew, take 2. Ham, take 2.
Fair.
That's fair. Okay.
And then, is How spicy would it be if I were to steal your Aetherflux?
Wouldn't be happy about it.
Sounds like you have to now. I mean,
I kind of wanna, but
sounds like you wanna fuck around and find out.
I do, but I will fuck around and find out this way. I'm gonna cast the Fairy's Ageless Insight, and I'll pay the one. If I would draw a card except the first one I draw each turn, I draw two cards instead.
In response. No, never mind. I forgot I was tapped.
Sadness resolves.
In response, ooh-woo.
Ooh-woo indeed. We'll tap the Felwar Stone, sacrificing the Mind Stone, and I'll draw not one, but two cards.
This is a nightmare.
Yep. There are two triggers of... Wait, no, hold on. Mm-hmm. Four triggers of two damage.
Yeah, you have eight damage.
Yeah.
Red.
two to Ham, two to Brew, two to Maul, two to Brew, and then two to Brew again. So four for Brew, two to Maul, and two to Ham. It's just that Aetherflux.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Too many bad memories.
It's not even doing anything. I'm actually not casting that much. Everything in my hand is so high drop.
And then we'll pass the turn.
Alright, groovy. On your end step, I'm gonna remove eight counters off my Ominouses and rock out a Kraken. Alright.
I feel and like then... Fredo's the problem right now with the fucking Sakashima, Teferi's, and Solfim.
You sure? I mean...
For now!
It's only completely destroying us. I don't know what you're talking about. Alright.
Yeah, I think we're dead in a turn or so.
If we that sounds right. Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm gonna go ahead and, yeah, draw for turn. Foreshadow counter, Niv trigger. Yeah, Fredo, I'm just going after your face on this one. Just pop, pop.
Absolutely understandable. Have a nice day.
I feel like that's fair. All right. I'm going to go ahead and play an island for turn.
We might be done then... by like 9:30 at this rate.
That's a possibility.
9:10 even.
I'm going to pay four. Actually, no. Yeah.
Like Gilded Lotus to Fairy's Ageless Insight, like Fredo. Solid, like, 70% chance he untaps.
Yeah, we need a...
100%, yeah. Alright, so... because of the Goblin Electromancer, I'm gonna pay 4 for a Lorien Revealed. This is gonna trigger Saheeli, rock out another servo. I am gonna pay the 1 for Fredo's Ristic.
But I get to draw?
You sure do.
We also draw. Everybody draws off of the Lorien Revealed, as well.
For yeah, everybody was in it. Yes, because because all Nivs are live. So yeah, there's the draw on the cast, and then Niv triggers all around.
Yeah. All right, how are we doing that?
So I need to target first.
Okay.
I think for this one. So wait. So this is gonna be 3 cards. I cast an instant. It's like, I'm gonna go ahead and this time I'm targeting Sakashima again. Hopefully I haven't messed it up horribly. And then, yeah, so then Mold, yeah, take it away.
I will also target Sakashima. Just
let's go!
Your math is wrong. Because the game ends. As somebody who plays a shitty Niv-Mizzet deck, a good Niv-Mizzet deck, we are dead in the water.
100%. Yeah, I'm over here playing shit Mizzet myself. I get it. Yeah.
Now I wish I was running Obliterate.
Fair enough. All right, so, Brew, who are you targeting?
Fredo. And I have...
Fredo's face?
Fair enough. O'Hare out.
4 damage?
Yes.
Yeah.
Alrighty. Well, when I draw 2.
Oh, no.
So I have... What's that?
Wouldn't that do 5 damage total?
Why?
So, O'Hare does...
Damage equals to O'Hare's power, which is...
4.
It's currently 4, isn't it?
Buffing. Is that a replacement effect for Niv?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Sorry, I misunderstood it.
No, all good.
Carry on. Right.
So I'll draw 2 cards. I'll have 4 stacks of damage, but in response, I'm going to tap my Gilded Lotus. so that we can have another cycle of fun. I'm gonna respond with a brainstorm.
You pay the one.
I will be paying the one this time.
Oh, the stack. Oh, the stack. All right.
Okay. I love this. Reminds me of the pod.
Okay, in response. Well, yeah. So that has... So while all the... So the Niv-Mizzet draw triggers are all going to hit the stack.
Yep.
In response to that, I'm going to cast a Salundi Visions.
What'd that do?
Look at the top six cards of my library. I may reveal an instant or sorcery card from among them, put it into my hand. But it triggers Niv, is really the idea.
Yeah. I will respond to that as well with one of my other blue floating mana, and I will swan song it.
Oh my god.
Okay.
I did pay for your Rhystic, by the way.
This works.
Fredo, yeah.
Do you pay the one? Are you paying the one?
But I do. We still all still draw off Niv. Oh my god, okay. What's happening?
So
all right.
Quit casting.
So at the top, right? At the top is Swan Song.
Yes.
All of us get a Niv draw.
Mm-hmm.
And then, Ham, you're the active player, so apply your Niv damage for Swan Song.
Well, so did the Niv draw... So then once the Niv draw resolves...
Yeah.
So Swan Song sticks, Niv draw. We draw my... I'm going to target Sakashima again.
Okay. Yeah. We're going to move to me. I'm going to target Sakashima again, so it's at one toughness. B, what are you going to target?
Fredo. All Fredo.
You fuck. You fuck.
What? Why?
No, we're done. What's going here?
It's fine.
Wait,
who are we supposed to be hitting?
So the thing is, so if Sakashima lives, we probably, at least one of us is dying in the resolution of this stack.
Oh,
so
okay.
Ham and I are trying to ping out one of the Niv copies.
Yeah, so if you put your 4 Niv damage onto Sakashima,
done.
That's going to solve a lot of our problems
done.
Here.
That's what I'm doing.
Because right now all the Niv draws are on the stack, but we haven't actually drawn those cards yet, so that's all potential damage later. We're trying to kill Sakashima at the top of this damn stack, otherwise we're going to get wrecked.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
All right.
So fuck Sakashima out of here. That's what I'm doing.
Alrighty. Then mine will go on the stack, but I will have 2 draws.
Yes, you will.
Yeah.
And 2 of those Sakashima triggers will still exist because the damage hasn't resolved yet.
Correct.
So we're just gonna go even on all my stacks. We're just gonna go around the table. So I'm gonna keep track of it with an infinite token on my side you guys cannot see. But I promise the math is accurate. Trust. So Ham will get one of the Sakashimas. Mald will get one. Brew will get one. And then back to Ham one.
Okay.
For that cycle of Swan Song damage, that is all 4 Niv triggers off the Swan Song. Okay. So then mine will resolve. Y'all will take... So
yeah,
Ham takes two damage or 2 sets of damage.
Total. I marked it. Yep. Yeah.
Then Mald will take 2.
2. I marked it.
Brew will take 2. Then Brew's damage will go. Sakashima gets marked for 4. Right.
Mm-hmm.
No.
Yes.
Is O'Hare to players or creatures?
Oh yeah. So Sakashima is marked with 1 damage. Okay.
So now they're down to 2 remaining.
Oh, so an opponent's dang. I didn't realize that. I'm sorry.
They still die to this round of it, but that is an important distinction.
Right.
And Mald, you're doing just 1, right?
Yeah, just 1.
Okay.
Oh, wait, it's all still part of the same sack. So Sakashima will be around for 1 more iteration because of
one
that.
More round, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, because then, so the Swan Song resolves. Salundi Visions is countered. However, and that makes a burp. We still have a round of Niv draws for the Salundi Vision cast, right?
Yes. Yep.
Okay. And so...
I've drawn for Niv.
We go around again. I'll draw for Niv on this one.
I'll draw 2.
And I'm targeting friggin' Sakashima again. Yeah.
I am once again targeting Sakashima.
Let's take that sucker out.
In transparency, that is now full lethal on Sakashima, so... Brew, you can start hitting my fucking face.
Yeet, bitch! Get it out of here!
Alright, let me get another infinite token to keep track of my face damage for my crimes.
I love how fucking wild this is.
Okay, mine will go on the stack. I have 4 triggers since Takashima's still alive. We'll do 1 to Brew, 1 to Malt, and then 1 to him, and then another to Brew.
Okay.
So that's 2 on Brew, 1 on Mald, and 1 on Ham? Yeah.
Yeah.
Sounds right.
So, 4 damage to Brew, 2 damage to Ham, 2 damage to Mald. Then, Brew's damage will go, I will go to 31.
Mm-hmm.
Mald's will resolve, hitting Sakashima. Ham's will resolve, hitting Sakashima. Sakashima is now fucking out of here.
Yay!
So then, the spell's countered. What else is resolving? Brainstorm?
Then your brainstorm. And then we all have Niv draws off the brainstorm, don't we?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. Another round of Niv draws. So I'm the active player still. So yeah. So we get that draw going up, and I'm gonna target. So Fredo, I'm targeting your Niv now. I'm seeing, can we take this out? Because yeah, I have Glorian Reveal at the bottom of the stack that's going to draw me 3 cards.
Yes.
So, yeah.
I will join you in that effort and target Fredo's Niv as well.
Okay.
Mald, you're a fucking legend. I need you to know that, okay?
That is 2 damage.
All right. Sick. And Brew, you got more? You got another trigger?
Fredo!
Is that another... Fredo.
Alright, that is pretty efficient with, I guess, O'Hare, yeah.
Yeah, oh my goodness. Yeah, 4 damage to the face every time? Oh, that's kind of silly.
8 damage. Alright, I've drawn 2 cards, and I'm now realizing I did the math wrong on Sakashima. Because Sakashima would have drawn me another 2 cards, we're not going back. This is the only way I'll learn.
Oh, are people paying the one? What?
No, it's just that Sakashima would have... Sakashima would have drawn me.
Theoretically, Fredo should have dealt twice as much damage.
Yeah, right. But we ain't doing that. There is 2 draws, so 2 sets of 2 damage. We'll assign that to Ham and Mald for this round.
Fair.
Go down to 18.
This is getting exactly as
Bruise damage,
ridiculous as I expected.
Bruise damage will hit me 1, 2, 3, 4. 1 mark damage on my Niv, another mark damage off of Ham.
Yep.
Okay. Now, this is gone. Brainstorm will resolve, correct?
Now Brainstorm resolves, yes.
Yeah.
So, I'll draw 1, 2, 6. 3, 6? Oh, yeah.
Teferi.
5, 6.
Brainstorming with the Teferis is one of the most powerful feelings you can have in the game.
Right? Yeah.
So, I will receive...
Yep.
24, yeah.
Okay.
Woof.
It's 24 divided by 3. What's the math on that?
By 2, you mean?
9-ish? Oh, sorry. Well, because there's 3 opponents.
Oh, by 3, yeah.
Yeah.
That's 8 each.
Yeah, each of you take 8.
Each? Yep. Your mother. Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
I appreciate this democratic approach you're taking here.
I mean, I had the most egregious board state. It only felt fair to me.
Yeah, because if you wanted the dogpile, you could have. So, yeah. I want to recognize that you're not doing that, and thank you. You're like, that's cool. Yeah.
Real-in based.
So that Brainstorm will resolve, and then your Lorien Revealed goes on now?
If Brainstorm's done resolving, then Lorien Revealed resolves, and I just draw 3 cards.
Oh, God.
Did we resolve those draws yet for each Niv?
No.
The Niv draws? No.
The Niv draws for Lorien.
Okay.
Yeah, we have not. So, yep. So there's another draw there. You're right. Draws all around. So there's 2 mark damage on Niv so far?
Yeah, 2. So to kill him, you need at least 3.
3. So I'm going to...
3 more damage.
The one off the Niv draw, I'm going to target it at your Niv again.
Okay.
And at this point, the Lorien reveal hasn't resolved. Man, I'm chucking this command tower every which way.
Just yeeting. Stop it.
Yeeting. To say.
Okay, and then my 1 damage will also go at Niv.
That's 4.
Mm-hmm.
And then B, you're up to assign.
Yep.
I'm what?
You got to assign your Niv damage.
How much do I get right now? Four?
Or if in my face, one to Niv.
Yeah. At this point, Niv has all but one damage, but I still have the Lorien Reveal to resolve. So at this point, you could wait, and I'm definitely going to target Niv.
Yeah, the replacement effect would be more efficient at my face.
100%. Yeah.
I wanted to blow up Solfim just to send a message.
It's indestructible.
Sorry, indestructible.
Oh, yeah.
I tried earlier. I tried.
Okay.
Sometimes you gotta make them have face. It, and sometimes they do.
Face.
Face. So I'll mark that here. I have two draws, 20 cards in hand. I don't know how the fuck this happened. I do have to put a few of those back because I misdid the brainstorm, so we'll do those.
Well, you put two back and then you draw two, so you get...
Yeah.
Yeah, kind of nets out. Yeah.
I love brainstorm so much.
Dude, brainstorm is amazing.
Yeah. Two to brew, two to ham, and then I take four, go to 23. Mald will mark one on Niv, and then where did yours go, Ham? On Niv as well?
Yes. So okay, I believe Niv still has, I believe there's been four damage on Niv so far.
I will now shut the fuck up. I'm sorry for taking lead on the stack.
No, thank you.
Oh, that was great. That was
somebody needed to. Appreciate you.
We are contractually obligated to attempt to take all your bones for it, but it was very cool.
Yes, and thank you. Definitely appreciate it.
I would show you the math, but it's kind of green screened. This is how I did it.
that rules. Thank you.
All right. Lorien Revealed.
Lorien Revealed is going to resolve after about 10 minutes of very eventful gameplay. And that's three triggers. I'm going to put one of them on Niv. Should be the last one there.
Yep.
And then... I don't know, Fredo, I'm just going to put one more on your face because, I mean, all the cool Ballad. Kids are doing it, so.
All the cool kids are doing it.
All right, it is what it is. All right. And I got this Kraken. I didn't get all dolled up for nothing. And that's three more counters on my Ominouses. Hells yeah. And I'm officially tapped out. So I'm going to go to combat.
Hell yeah.
Which is the thing that we're allowed
it's
to do. And I'm
going
to... I don't know. You got to do it sometimes. And you know what? Fredo, I'm going to put some commander damage on you. I'm going to send my lizard wizard at you. And
King Gizzard I probably, coming.
I feel like I should send this Kraken, but I'm not going to. I'm just going to go ahead and pass it. Because I've done enough. We've had enough of a turn.
All right. I'll draw for turn. The one Niv ping is going to go to Fredo's face.
For turn, I'm going to discard an island and a Chromos Sea Trick. So.
Okay. I'm going to play the Cascade Bluffs. I'm going to tap Thought Vessel and attempt to resolve the Basilisk Collar, which gives equipped creature Death Touch and Lifelink.
Are you paying the one?
I'm going to pay the one, yeah.
Ugh.
Twice?
You can have yours.
Yay!
What?
The Niv's gone.
What?
That's true, the Nivs are gone,
the
so
Niv's
yeah.
Gone. What the fuck do I care? does Basilisk Collar resolve?
I got nothing.
I'm tapped out.
Let me see if I have a free spell in my 20. No, you're good.
Okay. I'm gonna pay three more. I'm gonna attempt to resolve Robe of the Archmagi.
Are you paying the one?
Whenever equipped creature deals combat damage to a player, you draw that many cards. Equip Shaman, Warlock, or Wizard, one. I'm not paying the one for either of you. Does this resolve?
I still got nothing, unfortunately. Yep.
For either? Yeah.
I can't do anything. It resolves
okay.
for me.
So you, so B, you have a Niv trigger to apply somewhere.
Fredo.
Okay.
Now out of spite. For having an egregious board state to begin with.
And you have so once been up, yeah.
That's so real of you. I want you to hold on to that thought as the next stuff happens. I'm going to tap
Why
three
are you doing this?
To equip Basilisk Collar and Robe of the Magi to Niv Mizzet. I'm going to move the combat, Don't swing Niv Mizzet at Fredo. I'm going to hit you for five. I'll gain five. I'll draw five cards.
Indeed. And proceed to murder the board. Yeah.
I'm going to apply one damage to Ham's Niv. I'm going to apply one damage to B's Niv. I'm going to apply one damage to O'Hare. I'm going to apply one damage to your 8-8 Kraken. And the final damage is going to the Goblin Electromancer.
Seems good.
So B, all your shit is gone.
Yeah.
So I would kindly request that you get it the fuck out of my face. And I will gain five more life.
How much all my shit? All my creatures? Or
yes.
All, yeah.
Niv has Death Touch. So yep. All of Niv's pings kill in one now.
Got it. Seems good. Yeah.
See, yeah.
That's
Artifact Gaming.
Let's go.
I also made meta calls, and then I'll pass. Oh, and then
well
I'll...
Played. Well
my
played.
My Chasm Skulker is a 10-10 now.
I don't like that.
I hear that's good. Yeah.
Okay.
Well, that got out of hand fairly quickly.
Yeah, well, listen, as we were going through it, and I got the robe through that fucking incredibly long turn, I was like, oh, there's a chance.
Yeah. Hell yeah. All right, birds and servos, you got this.
Sorry, having a hard time with what I want to do. I really, really, really wanted to do something, but I'm like one off from it, and I know I'm not going to live another round. And I'm so sad.
We've reached that point in the game where,
All right. I'm gonna put out. I have a Jeweled Lotus, so let's put that out. I have this fucking land. Comes out on tap, that's all that matters. What the fuck is Niv now? 8? Alright, so I'm gonna crack the Jeweled Lotus for 3 red. Blue, 7, 8. No, calm yourself. One of them, thank you. Recast, Niv.
You gain one life?
Yes, I gain a life.
Do you pay the one for me?
I pay the one. None of this is useful. I'm so mad right now. That's gonna be it. This is very unfortunate. Pass turn.
Alrighty.
Oops. Sorry. Ignore that. You didn't see it.
Lay a reliquary tower because I refuse to discard any of this.
I don't blame you.
Oh, real.
Fair. Yeah, good shout. Yep.
There was an ancient tomb, but at 7 life, I don't know about that.
Yeah.
Let's see. There is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 creatures out. Is that correct?
I have three.
One.
Yeah.
And I have one.
8 total.
Yeah. Okay. Let's start anew. I'm gonna Blasphemous Act.
God bless you. Oh,
fair play.
That is a sorcery, I believe. So we all get a round of shit.
To me.
Are you paying the one?
I'll draw.
Yes.
Damn it.
I have to.
My one damage is going to be directed at Fredo's face.
Understandable.
And that's lifelink, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. So
hell yeah.
And then my equipment stay. This is 13 total damage, right? Because it's the old Blast Act.
Yep.
Okay, so I will make 10. Or so I will make 11 1-1 squids.
I forgot about that.
Seems good. Seems good.
That's amazing.
All right. Carry on.
Let's, Yeah. Oh, Brew, you have one damage as well.
Okay.
No, for you to give to somebody, not to yourself.
All right, Mald, you have too much health. I'm gonna ping you.
Oh yeah, no, I absolutely do. After the turn I took, I expect nothing. nothing but homicide to follow.
Needs doing.
Just needs. Doing. Let's put out my own jeweled lotus, and we'll use the lotuses and the Felwar Stone and Reliquary Tower to repay for Niv Mizzet.
You're paying the one.
You can have it. Yay. Let's attempt a. We'll tap for two. I'm gonna cast Harmonic Prodigy.
Oh, hello.
Hey, Fredo. Hey.
Yes. You can have it. And then I will finish my magic tricks with a reflecting pool into a faithless looting.
Mm-hmm.
Good. You got a lot of Niv triggers, just chilling.
So faithless looting will trigger Niv. I'll draw two. There's two stacks of two damage. We'll shoot it all at Mald for four.
Well, so with Niv, you'd be drawing twice because of the Harmonic Prodigy. Yeah, you have four damage pings, right?
Thing. Oh, so I draw two twice?
They're two separate triggers. And so you draw them, you draw, which means you then double the damage.
Draw triggers, which then get doubled by Teferi's. So you have...
Oh god, I forgot about that one too.
So you have four cards come into your hand,
okay,
which you get to shoot four times for it, two damage each.
You get to shoot eight times because Harmonic Prodigy doubles the ping triggers.
Oh,
it?
The ping trigger too. Yeah, so you have 16
and this
damage.
Is,
you have
16 and that's just off of casting it.
Yeah.
Fredo, your face!
I'm pretty sure, I think you may have just won the game with that face.
Oh yeah, no, the game's over.
Yeah, you know, it's...
Yeah.
You have enough damage to, you can just shoot it at face and we all die.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, you got more than 30 damage. Oh, yeah, let's do that.
GG, fucking Fredo. I was getting like so anxious, and I didn't want to die because on my turn I had Triska Decaphile.
Oh my god.
And in all my decks, I have at least one card that I know is not going to win me the game, and I shouldn't have it, but I want to just cast it once that I had it in my hand. I had Spelljack. I don't know if anybody has had the privilege of resolving a Spelljack, but oh.
It's very funny. You love that card.
I wanted it so badly. But yeah, anyway. Dude, good game.
It was a good great game.
That got exactly as ridiculous as it needed to.
Oh my god, yeah.
So funny. I appreciate that. And I appreciate you guys. Holy shit.
If you do another Niv pod, you should get Chukimon off of TikTok, because...
I love Chuki! He signed up for Tayum next year.
Ah, nice.
Yeah, also in my hand, I had Solfim. I had another Niv. I had a Hull Breaker. And then I had Sun Quan to give everybody horsemanship.
Nice.
That's delightful. Yes.
I feel like I always need a piece of absolutely unhinged wincon, and like just slap face with horsemanship is weird. That's weird in a Niv deck.
I mean, it people do not see it coming, I'm sure.
Yeah. Mald, the amount of fucking tokens you have right now.
Yeah, I mean, the real plan was Arjun.
Mm.
That was who the real homie was.
Okay.
I never got to him. I mean... Basila's collar was the Niv pod pick of like
that. Yeah, that was nuts, dude. Yeah, the moment you dropped that and the cloak, it was like, oh wait, this, yeah, Mald went from a non-issue to the issue very quickly.
Yeah, I went from the baby who had stood in the corner to the baby found a gun.
Yep. 100%. Yeah, how did he get that? Yep.
absolutely fucking correct. And this is the energy I appreciate about you.
And I gotta say as well, I really appreciate just the vibe of this particular pod. Like, most people I play with are really good about it, but y'all are... The amount of, like, sportsmanly shit-talking was dead on, but when it actually came down to resolving, like, that incredibly ridiculous stack, like, the amount of just respectful, you know, dialogue and everything, it was awesome. Thank you, everybody. This is great.
I try really, really hard to balance personalities in pods, and I felt like you and Fredo are the more chill war criminals, and me and Mald are the more salty war criminals. I felt like it was nice. It would dilute the salt a little bit.
I think that was fair. Yeah. Right?
No, but I had a good time. I agree. This was silly. I'm a little sad I didn't get to pull, like, my fire emancipation.
I mean, I'm sure we all have tech that we wish we could have seen. But,
oh,
yeah.
My God, yeah. There's a ton of things where it's like, honestly, even in not in an all-Niv pod, if you let a Niv Mizzet player resolve that, you deserve to die.
100%. Like, oh, yeah.
You earned that, John.
I think I'm going to start slipping Aetherflux into all my...
Stop it.
That's pretty legit.
All of my Salt Factory decks are going to start having Aetherflux in it because I'm starting to really fall in love with the alternate win con of just like, yeet, you win.
I mean, the thing is, Commander is, unless you're playing four Nivs, is often so slow. Like, casual Commander is so slow a format that any deck that has blue could probably find a space that deserves to be cut for Aetherflux, just because if you're in blue, it's like, fair chance.
100%.
Fair chance you'll take a turn that gains you, like, 6+ life.
Yep.
Yeah.
Very, very but, true.
Yeah, this is legit. And I gotta say, this went from this deck I expected to just kind of slap together and just set aside.
It did well!
Terranborg Expanse was the... But I think I'm honestly gonna keep this. And, yeah. Because this is delightful. This was super fun.
Like it's one of my like $70 version that I first built is one of my favorite decks to play.
Hell yeah.
Hey, we got a raid. What up, Trying Casually? Thank you so much for the raid. How is your stream? Although this game's about ending. Chat, stick around after this game. I'll be back in like 10-15 minutes and we're gonna play some late night magic unless you guys wanna play another game.
No, I have to go back to missing takes on how to convincingly wink. Watch out for that video though. When I fucking get it, I swear to God, when I get you, Ricky.
I want Ricky,
when I get you.
I want the outtake reel. I want 10 minutes of Mold winking. That's what
one of my Patreon rewards is a blooper reel, and you can be goddamn sure the entire blooper reel this month is a 10 minute winking montage.
Let's go. That's what the people want. Yeah. That's the content the people want. Oh,
I gotta start taking bloopers. That's a good idea.
Hey Omega.
But yeah, why don't you guys do a little side off? I'll go to a be right back screen and then I will in fact be right back and we'll play some magic. We can go in turn order again. Fredo, who the hell are you?
Hi everyone, I'm Fredo Virtue MTG. You can see myself using the gravity of my opponent's lands with a flame geyser to whip myself into interstellar speeds on Niv decks like tonight. But other than that, I love playing Commander. I have pet rats that may or may not make an appearance before this all ends. I keep promising that, but they are not appearing.
I want the babies!
I hope my partner and or an invisible hand appears and brings them before the end of the stream. But other than that, I had an absolute blast. I don't ever want to resolve triggers this silly ever again, but I will probably do it.
I'm glad you were willing to give it a chance and legit.
We got one.
Oh my god, that was a legitimate response on my part. I keep responding that way in Baldur's Gate to all of the animals, so I need to actually. I'm working on a like series of clips of just me freaking out at animals in Baldur's Gate.
That's lovely.
But yeah, thank you so much for giving it a chance and being part of this pod. It was very, very fun to have you.
Absolutely.
Ham.
Hello, hello. So hey everybody, my name's Graham. I go by HamHox42 on the internet. And I stream here on Twitch, twitch.tv/HamHox42, Jammin' Arena. We're all about janky brews, and I'm generally a graveyard enthusiast, so is a little outside my wheelhouse, but I gotta say, this was exactly as ridiculous and fun as I wanted it to be. So yeah, Bruja, thank you so much. And is it cool if I post a little link tree in chat?
Yeah, please do.
I kind of assumed, just wanted to double check.
All your shit. I want everybody to be supported.
And Brujaja and I actually host a show called Hot Soup that is super duper fun. It is exactly as if you ever want to see the two of us just kind of unhinged, like geek out about Commander things. I have good news. That show exists, and it's
we
really
also
fun.
Like just take topics from people that yes, want 100%. To hear what we like think about stuff mm-hmm. or recommendations or deck techs coming up. 100%.
All that stuff. Yeah. So yeah. So, thanks for having me.
Of course.
Good times.
Love having you, and I'm glad.
I have a new dragon commander now, and I'm very excited about that.
Yeah, I loved your deck. The fact that it was a $93 deck and it kicked that much ass, like, just because you weren't the immediate threat doesn't mean you didn't fucking hold solidly that threat.
It's got an absolute trash mana base with a handful of cool synergy pieces. You know, I had things like, you know, Stormkill Nardis. That's a good, you know, $5 card right now. And
like,
I got it in there.
I feel like out
dollars. I think it got reprinted recently. Anyway,
I feel like outside of a Niv Mizzet pod. It'll do great.
I sure hope so. Yeah. I might make a couple of tweaks though, because I have a few things in there, like Red Elemental Blast, for example, that I happen to have one. It's like, well, I know my opponents are gonna be casting blue, so
let's do it.
Yeah, I know. That was medical, but anyway. But yeah, again, thank you so much.
Of course, Mild.
Hey everybody, I am down there on the bottom right with the squids. I am a soon-to-be professional shit poster that you can find on YouTube and TikTok, touching cards, trying to touch your heart, and most importantly, telling you whether or not I would touch your commander's parts. Thank you very much to Bruja for having me. Niv is my personal favorite commander, and so it hurts so good to watch one cave my face in.
This year I started adding extra pods specifically geared towards certain like creators that I knew would be a fan of that. And like the first one I did was with Dino Dez. I had to make a Gishath pod for the boy. How could I not? And I knew Niv was your favorite commander. I'm like, I have to have Mald. No way I can't have Mald.
Goddamn right.
But seriously, thank you so much for being here. I absolutely love having you on the channel. I love having all of you on the channel. And I know a few of you are signed up for future Salt Factory pods. I am like scheduled through 2024, which is exciting. So again, chat, stick around. I will be back in a little bit. Dad Jokes and Cardboard, thank you so much for the raid. Don't go anywhere. I love you guys. Wait, where's my BRB screen? I have too many scenes. Transition.